A very pleasant and auspicious morning to one and all. Today, we all are celebrating World Women's Day. Our Telugu Maria teacher and also student. We are fortunate here that Nirmala Hrudhaya school campus is fortunate because now we have with us 7 eminent doctors of Nizamabad district who have come all along to educate you. Usually we think that men are more stronger than women. Today, women has proved that she can do everything and anything, but there are certain things which only a woman can do and wonderful. Today with us, we have the 7 doctors here who are conducting a program on account of Women's Day about menstrual hygiene and management and also career orientation. First and foremost, Dr. Rama Devi, who is a very eminent doctor, who is also the president of Nizamabad Obstetric and Gynecological Society. Dr. Sujata Garu, a warm welcome to you, madam. Dr. Malleshwari Garu, a very warm welcome to you, madam.
Nowhere less. Don't think women are weaker section. we are all strong. We are mentally strong, maybe physically a little weak, because our God has given a structure to us to have, like, to bring up children and to have pregnancies and all those things. And we have some, every month we have some problems where we become weak, but still we are so strong. We are multifaceted. You are a working lady. For example, you take your teachers. They are mother at home. They are teachers with you. They cook. They take care of their children. They come here. They teach you people. Go back. Take care. So many. And suppose we are not doctors here. In spite of doing all our profession, we are all at home. Almost we are housewives taking care of children like any other lady. So we are more stronger than women. And at a time when husbands are having some trouble, some problem, we stand beside them. We give them a hand. We support them. And we bring him up. So you should always be proud to be a woman. And with this small introduction, I request Dr. Aruna to come and take a look about some health tips, how to take care of your health.
Thank you for leading us through the program here. A very happy Women's Day to all the school management, and also advanced happy Women's Day to all the talented girls of Nirmala Hrudhaya. Today I will be talking few points on the menstrual hygiene management. And to start with, if I have to ask you, like, how many of you got a new dress last week? How many of you would have put up your hands? Yes. And how many of you went to a restaurant last week? Yes. And if I have to follow this with a question, like, how many of you are in your menstrual periods today? Can I have the hands up in their menstruation today? So I would like to talk on the management of menstrual hygiene. We are talking of big things like fighting for women's rights in the properties, and then having abuse at the work area, exploitation, and then going big in all the areas of other fields. But we are ignoring the simple things like how to manage our menstruation. The menstrual hygiene management, with the definition, goes as: it is the use of a neat and absorbent napkin during the menstruation and the proper disposal of the material you are using during menstruation. And this is because 52% of the women globally are in the reproductive age group. And then it is default, like a sign of femininity, is we having menstruation every month. So no longer should we feel ashamed about talking about the menstruation. And then a little bit cautious if you are not getting your periods by the age of 16 years. Each one is supposed to have regular menstruation roughly around 28 to 35 days, with a normal flow between 3 to 5 and the variable between 2 to 7 days. And then how would you manage your menstruation? This is by using an absorbent napkin. It can be a sanitary pad or a cloth. So what would be the advantages with a sanitary napkin? It is easy to use and very easy to dispose a sanitary napkin. It keeps your area dry, and then it prevents the soreness. It goes accordingly, it follows, it keeps the area dry, and the infection rate is less with napkins. And then your movement or mobility during the menstruation for all the activities is good with the sanitary napkin. And how do you use a cloth? Why are we talking about the cloth? Because a few people still are not having access to the sanitary napkin because of the cost factor. Many women in India still use cloth during the menstruation. So how do you dispose of cloth? You're supposed to wash it properly, and then you're supposed to dry it in a sunny area. Ideally, before use, you're supposed to iron it, and then you're not supposed to use the cloth for multiple uses. Once it gets dirty, you are supposed to dispose it, and you are not supposed to share the cloth with others. Then, what are the techniques you need to follow, or the steps you need to follow during menstruation? You are supposed to use a clean pad daily, and ideally for every 6 to 8 hours, you are supposed to change the napkin. And then, if the bleeding is more, you are supposed to change it every 3 to 4 hours. You should never let the napkin completely, and then you are supposed to have a bath daily. And then while changing the napkin, you are supposed to wash your hands cleanly before and after the use of the napkin. phenomena, nothing to be feared about. So you can talk to your friends who have already had a menstruation, you can talk to your parents or to the teachers, whoever is accessible to you, don't feel ashamed, and then you can come out in public during menstruation. Nothing to feel bad like your breast got stained or you did not carry a pad with you. Always it is ideal, like whenever you are going out, you change the pad before going out and then carry enough pads with you when you are not aware like what the outside situation would be like. And then the school management, teachers are going to help out the girls with the knowledge of the menstruation, and they need to provide soaps for possible emergency pads availability at the school and enough water supply, and then give privacy to the girls to change their napkins. And that's it. And if you have any questions, you can inquire with all of us later. Thank you so much.
Children, and we also have emergency napkins in every class cupboard. In case of requirement, they can use it and they substitute it afterwards with another napkin. And the privacy is given, and there are dustbins separate for disposing the napkins also. Very, very thank you very much, madam, for giving a complete brief but in detail all the details about PRP and menstruation. Now I would like to call Dr. Maheshwari Garu to say some words about Women's Day and menstrual hygiene to our students.
Details of the Women's Day and the importance of it, and later you are all in teenage, means you are adolescents. From 30 to 19, it is the adolescent age group. There you are supposed to plan for your future, and you should not be like the frogs in the well. You should know what is what, what you are interested for, and what you should do, what you should plan for the future. And this career orientation counseling is the foundation step for your future. In some places like California, they spend almost 1 year for career planning. That is the stage there. And here also, we should spend few days or few months with our relatives or friends so that we can plan for our career, in which branch you are interested for, whether it is technical or research oriented or artistic, creative, like that you should plan. If you are creative, in relation to mechanical things, you can plan for engineering. If you are research oriented, you can plan for space, spaceships, NASA and all. And if you are creative, that is for paintings, like that you can plan for. These are all the career orientation things. And if you, like, when you go for a hotel, you can choose your things, what you need. I want idli, I want dosa, whether your mom accepts it or not, I want it only. Like that, when you plan for your future also, you can take the help of your teachers, and then you can plan with their guidance so that you can make your parents accept your choice. That is the situation. And nowadays, so many branches are there. Whatever somebody asks, what you want to do? I want to be a doctor, I want to be an engineer. Previously, we are not having that passion to doctor, to do professional things. Nowadays, even financial analysts, income tax things, and IAS officers, so many are there, and you can choose your things as per the counseling and everything. And if you are interested in sports, that's not a minor thing. People are thinking that playing games is not a good one, and you are wasting your time. Please don't think that way. You can have your physical stamina and you can go through the sports quota also. And moreover, you have to plan for exercise timings and yoga so that that gives your self-confidence and you can plan your own things and own careers. By seeing someone, you can be inspirational. When you see your relative settling in USA, I do want to go to USA. Before going to US, how much this struggle you cannot assess. So you have to plan in the beginning itself. Whether it is intermediate or degree, that is not the criteria. Just aim at the sky. You will reach at least the top of the tree. May not be you will be able to fly over the sky, but you can reach the top of the tree. And moreover, when wealth is lost, something is lost, and when character is lost, everything lost. So maintain your health and character. That helps a lot in your future. And you are the stepping stones for the Thank you.
Malishwar madam career gurinchi cheppar. So I will tell you few things which are very important for your life. So one entante naaku a teenage girl undi. So I know. So first of all, in entante you have to protect yourself from the society. Ante you should know what is bad touch, what is good touch. So meer evvani kuda mee risk ni ki rani kuda chusukondi. Nobody should touch you. So meer mimmani protect chesukondi. That is very very important.
Second thing, you should be very healthy to achieve all these things. study more hours. So if you want to study more hours, you should have strength first of all. So for the strength, you need energy. So if you eat well, you will get the energy. So have a nutritious diet, have good habits, and taking a protein diet every day makes you feel better and you can achieve your goals. And I think my lecture is clear to everyone. So having nutritious meal every day and become, you know, focused and have a good attitude, and then you can achieve anything, whatever you want to become. Thank you one and all.
Who have given you a guidance about how to take care of yourself during menstruation, and what are the steps you have to follow for hygiene, way of maintaining yourself during menstruation, about the career guidance they spoke to you, about the nutrition they spoke to you. You have anything to ask, any doubts you have, any problem you are facing during menstruation. See, this is very good opportunity for you all. Usually we go to doctors and now doctors are here with us. Let us utilize. Anybody has got any questions? Can come and ask.